Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dalton, and today we're playing ourselves some RuneScape. So, got a lot of crap to go over with this game, guys. Check out my character, he looks pretty cool if you ask me. Look at that, this is the old school RuneScape. You know, they've made like quite a few of them since this game came out. But like, apparently a lot of people still play this one. So, I started playing this one about a little over a month ago. And it's like a real relaxing game. Because no one can attack you in the game. Well, unless it's like a computer player. But it's an online game. Well, people can attack you, but you gotta be up in the wilderness. So the cool thing about it is that I just got a thing yesterday. And it's called OS Buddy. And it like helps out with the game a lot. Like, you can't usually go inside of this map and look around. It's only because I got an OS buddy that I can. You know, that makes the game like a lot easier to navigate. So I'm on this white dot right here. I'm up in Caterby. You know, and I've been fishing lobsters over here, folks, with my lobster pot. And you know, I'll tell you why. It's because you got a bunch of different skills, as you can see right here. Oh yeah, I wanted to show you the wilderness. So I zoomed out a lot, I'm right there. You know, like, I think it's like, hold on, we gotta zoom out a bit. Okay, that's all we can do. Let me try to find it. Yeah, that's the wilderness up here. You know, anyone can, you know, kill anyone up there. So if you go up there with a bunch of good items and stuff, and you die, holy crap, you ain't getting them items back because they fall on the ground. Well, unless whoever, you know, hurt you, unless they don't pick them up and you run back and try to get them. So anyway, guys, I was showing you these skills I've got. The cool thing is you can click this map or the, you know, the world to run. Let's go catch some lobsters. Hold on, I gotta go to the cage fishing spot. Those are nets. That guy's at a cage one, but I like to try to get my own if I can. There we go, folks. And check it out. There he is, boys. In all his glory, he is catching some lobsters. We got 27 inventory slots for lobsters. So, you know, we got all these stats, guys. Holy crap, we got a lobster. And them lobsters, while I'm fishing right now, my fishing levels will go up. So I'm level 44 fishing. You know, fishing and cooking are my highest levels right now. So these are all the levels, guys. We got attack, hit points, mining, hold on, attack, strength, and defense. Them, you know, them three go like hand in hand. Then, you know, as you upgrade these three by attacking and stuff, your combat level will go up. So I'm level 38. So if someone like hovers over my guy, you know, it'll say level 38. Also, I think doing magic can like upgrade your combat level too, folks. But you know, the attack is if you're like, you set your types of combat right here, so this punch is attack experience, kick is strength experience, so strength, attack, and the block is defense. So you'll, then we'll go up depending on which one you choose. You know, guys, I don't got no weapons on me because I'm just fishing right now. But I wanted to show you guys some of the stuff about the game before I start playing. You know, just in case there's anyone that ain't never played before. Got a big hot cup of joe. And oh, wait, crap. That tastes real good, folks. You know, I put some pumpkin spice creamer in there from the Coffee Mate. And that stuff tastes pretty good. Okay, back to the game, folks. You know, down here is like the chat log. People can chat when they're near ya. That's real. Where is that a real guy? No, none of these people are real. They're all NPCs. Wait a minute, that's a real man. Level 100. Holy crap. He's level 100. Looks like he's coming to fish some lobsters too. Or it could be harpooning. So, let's go through all of these. You know, like levels or whatever. Hit points, mining. That's like smacking diamonds and ores. Strength, agility. You upgrade agility by doing agility courses. You know, I got to 31 agility yesterday. You know, went from 1 to 31, so I was pretty happy about that. Let me show you something real quick, guys. You know, right over here, this is stamina. Why the heck ain't my mouse showing up? That's weird. Hold on, let me change that setting. We'll see if I can change that while we're recording. I don't know if we can, folks. Oh, you know what? Hold on a sec. Let's see. Let me do the settings. Well, might not be in set. Hold on. Let me look at this crap. Properties. Yeah, I did the capture mouse. Well, guys, I guess we'll have to figure that out later, folks. For now, you can't see my mouse. Oh, now you can. What the heck? What, something's fishy. Because we're fishing, get it? Hold on, let me show you these things. You know, it's gone again. Oh, until you click, okay. Because it don't register that it's on the page. That makes sense. Okay. So, over here, that's your stamina. You know, when this is gold, it means you're in sprint mode. When it's that, you're in walk mode. What the heck is this? To be honest, I don't even know what the hell that is. You know, I'll have to learn. You know, right now, guys, I'm showing you everything that I've learned so far. And I've still got a lot to learn, like, you know, it took me like over a month to learn this stuff. as a genie, sometimes random crap will happen. And you know, like a genie or someone will show up and you gotta talk to them. So what was we was talking about this. That's Brent. And that's your prayer level. Prayer amount or something. And it's your hit points. That there's the compass. Click that and it'll go back to your default north. And it's the map exclusive to RuneScape, buddy. Oh, it's old OS, buddy, rather. So we're on the beach getting some crabs while I'm explaining some stuff. You know, this game is pretty relaxing, folks. You know, I would say that I'd like to sit here and level up. Because it's kind of like rewarding to level up. You know, I'm still 44 fishing, but we ain't, well, you know, the higher level you get, the longer it takes to get levels, folks. So let me finish going over these, but also, see, that's my experience bar. You know, let me show you some. If you click on these, it'll show you what you can do at certain levels. So, like that, level 1, you get shrimp, fish, shrimp. Level 5, sardines. Carambe, you can get with level 5 if you're a member. You know, herring, you can get with level 10. Anchovies, level 15. You know, guys, I only just became a member yesterday. And you know, there's a lot of stuff you could do without member. But there's a lot of stuff you could do with membership, too. You can get do more stuff. So these are showing you all the fish you can get. And, you know, at which levels you can fish them. So at 45, we can... Well, 46, we can fish bass with a big net. What the heck happened? Did we get full? No. Oh, we're still going. So, let me finish. We got smithing. That's like making armors and stuff. Defense is from, like, doing a defense attacks. Herblore, I don't know what the heck that is, because I ain't done it yet. It's making potions and stuff. So you can get, let's see, at level 3 you get an attack potion. You know, I ain't fought people in this game yet. Only like, you know, like computer players. Well, I see what it's doing every time I go into these. It stops me fishing. So, 44 fishing is fishing, you know, at the beach. You find these fish icons on the map. When I cover up the map with my webcam, but they're on the map. So, 20 ranged, so that's like bow and arrows. 5, thieving, and that's like pickpocketing. And it goes up when you pickpocket people. Let's look at that crud. Level 1, you can do a man. Level 10, farmer. Level 15, female ham follower. I guess they like pigs a lot of their ham followers. Following pigs all over the countryside. Rogue, cave goblin, holy crap, elf. Stalls. Oh, you can pick pocket stalls and chests. You know, I'm still learning a lot. Cooking, so that's like cooking up any foods you find. You can cook up different foods for whatever level you are. You know, at I just, at 44, well, actually, let's check, folks. 44, if we could, for swordfish, cold guys. Prayer level, that's like praying at places, and that goes up if you pray. Crafting, so like if you make crap, you can smelt stuff. Or wait, no, that's, I did a bunch of it. I think I did, like, yeah, gloves and stuff. I made some leather stuff and got to 35. Get in there, you dang butthead. Okay. Fire making, so you burn a fire on the ground. Magic, so that's like shooting magic spells as a mage. Fletching, which is like making arrows and stuff, I think. Wood cutting, so that's chopping down trees, folks. Rune crafting, so that's like making runes. So runes make it so you can teleport and stuff. And they also make it so you can do magic spells. My foot's the one that's labeled on. Get another sip of that. But that's some good crap. Slayer, I ain't done that. Farming is like planting corn and tilling the fields or something. Construction is building stuff. Hunter, hunting different birds and butterflies and imps. Deadfall, box traps. Holy crap, there's so much. You know, guys, I'm barely cracking the dang ice. What I know so far about this game, you know, there's like a lot of stuff, and you know, as it, I guess I'll learn the rest of it with you guys. So right down there is my total level, it's almost 500, and it's pretty cool. Let's take a look at some of these are quests. Folks, I ain't done any, I've done like, you know, like one quest. So that's got what we're gonna rely on to have some fun in these episodes. Is doing like quests, folks. You know, I don't know where the heck you get them. I was speaking of Sir Amic Forest at the White Knight Castle in Falador. I must have 12 quest points. Holy crap, they tell you what you gotta do. That's pretty cool. Only got one quest point, folks. So, we're gonna have to find something. Well, we can be a cook assistant. Maybe we should do that. That sounds pretty easy. So, that's a quest tab, okay. And that's your attack types. You can change them. Okay, we filled our inventory with lobsters. So I'm gonna go cook these bad boys up to try to get some more cooking. That's why these is pretty even. You know, it's cause simmer. I've been doing the both hand in hand, folks. Cooking and fishing. Very relaxing, folks. You can smack on a tree if you feel. Well, you can grapple. What? Is there a grappling hook in this game? You can chop down trees. I don't got an axe. Oh, it's in the bank. Okay, this is my gear. I ain't wearing any armor right now, folks. So there ain't nothing here, because I'm just doing fishing. And armor tends to slow you down. Unless you buy some special crap that's like, you know, helps your stamina speed or something. So these are prayers, and they help you. Rock skin increases your defense. Bam, folks. Mystic will increases your magic attack and keeps draining these dang prayer points. Better turn them off, folks. Okay, these are my spells. Magic. This is the only one I can cast. Because you don't need nothing for it. You just warp back to Lumbridge, which is the first town in the game, folks. Whoa, enchant crossbow bolt, I can cast that. Holy crap. Wow, folks. So, you need runes to do these. That's a spell. Spell. Holy crap. I didn't know I was draining prayer points. I totally turned it off. That's okay. Fire strike. So we got a few teleportation spells. Varrock teleport. Take you over to Varrock. It's not our town. What the? Okay, so this is Lumbridge home, and that's just Lumbridge. Falador teleport. Camelot teleport. Hang on a second. 45 magic. I'm at 33, so. Hang on, let's check that magic. Yeah, we're at 33. You know, there's a lot of crap in this game, guys. So you gotta either look it up on the internet, or, you know, like, I have, like, a friend who plays, been playing since probably 2000 and, like, 2 or some crap, or 3. So he taught me a lot of this stuff. And then I looked some on the computer, too. Okay, let's go to the bank. Let me burn these lobsters quick. Go to this pod icon in this town. So we're in Catcherby right now. Okay, let's burn these boys. And there's a stove so I can make a fire. Or you go to this stove. Let's cook them, folks. Cook, press on one of them. Click on the range. How many? How about all of them? Thank you, folks. Check them out. Some of our lobsters that are ready to go, folks. These boys are raw ones. And that man's a burnt lobster. You know, when you burn them, it ain't no good for nothing. So you throw them on the ground like a piece of crap. Because that's what they is. So this is a man. He ain't a controlled player. We're gonna advance a cooking level. Holy crap. I can feel it coming, folks. It's about to happen. Can we do it before we run out of lobsters? It's all down to the wire now. Holy crap. Let's do it. We got it. We're getting to 45. Holy. There it is, boys. You can now cook meat pizza and swordfish. And you can cook Barak fish and fluxia bats. Cook them last two, sons of guns. You can just say 5 if you only got 2. There we go, folks. Now what I'm gonna do. You know, there's a lot of crap you can do to be efficient in this game. And like, my brain ain't so quick at thinking sometimes. Well, I got some coffee, so I'm a lot quicker on my feet. But let me show you what I do as you talk, you bank with the banker. I got a lot of crap, but it's been over a month of some steady play. Fun game, very relaxing. So, look at that gold, folks, almost 1 million. And I got a lot of gold from my friend. But I also made 100k yesterday by doing agility courses. And trying to get these marks of grace while you're doing agility courses. And then you could go give them marks of grace to a woman named Grace. And then you can get diamonds for them. You go sell the diamonds. And you get a lot of money. Yes, that's a good grab. Deposit all the lobsters, boys. Holy crap, we got 151 lobsters. You know, them will heal you pretty well. So that's the cool part, is that they're a pretty good healing item. But I guess a shark is a pretty good one, too. You know. Okay. So them burnt lobsters, we're gonna deposit all of them in the bank. And then we're gonna do something where you withdraw them as a note. So a note. You know, normally if I withdrew all of these, all 9 of them would go in my inventory and take up a lot of space. So if I wanted to drop these worthless pieces of crap easier and quicker, you know, I would make them a note. And I would withdraw all of them. And now it's just a note. So it's like an IOU slip, but like, they're still there. So you drop them all and it's just a note. And like, you could do that with other stuff too. You could, you know, like, there's a place called the Grand Exchange. And that's where all the boys buy and sell their items. Oh, I suppose there's some girls up there too. But not many I've seen in my travels across these wastelands. So, the Grand Exchange is in Varrock. It's above Varrock. I think there's a few Grand Exchanges, if I ain't mistaken, though. Do a quick check. Hold on here. So we're up in Caterby. Valador, White Knight Castle. Drainers. Lumbridge. That there's the first town, folks. And this place is pretty cool. It's called Algarid. It's like a desert. It's like, you know, Arabia or something like that. You know, a lot of men with, like, wearing, like, Aladdin-looking stuff in there. Like, you know, you ever seen Aladdin from Disney? Okay, folks. What are we looking for? We're looking for, Varrock right now. You know, I could also go on Google and I could get myself a big old map on my monitor and check it out, because this one only goes so big. But like I said, guys, I don't know much yet about where the stuff is. Where the heck is Varrock? I'll find it, don't you worry, folks. The Grand Exchange is right above Varrock. Well, I mean, I don't gotta find it on the map. We can explore it. If we teleport, let me look at this. Varrock teleport costs 1 fire rune, 3 air runes, and 1 mind rune, I think them are. Whoops, that's... But there's a fire rune, a wind rune, and like a law rune. Oh, you, and I got a staff of, so I don't need to use that middle one, I think. You know, like that middle one, I got a staff of air. So it don't, you don't got to, use a rune if you got the staff of air. Staff of Air, there we go, folks. Stick it in the inventory. How many was it? I don't even remember. It's been like 8 years since I looked. Well, let me see. Okay. One fire, one law, folks. Bank. One fire. One law. And here we go, and we can teleport to Varrock, boys. Let's stick to... I ain't carrying the staff, so I gotta wield it. You gotta have it on your hand. Well, you know, there is one last obligatory thing we gotta do is... We gotta be a frog. We gotta be a frog man to do this. Kermit. The adventures. Kermit. So, what the heck are we doing? Here it is, Varrock boys. Off to Varrock. And that was a pretty quick warp, folks. Oh, you got magic points for doing that. That's cool. I never knew you could... Oh, there's an agility course over there. I think I already did it. What the heck is this guy doing? He's practicing warping. I wonder if there's a bank over here. Well, guys, get ready. We might see some swear words. A lot of boys up there like to get rowdy. And, you know, it's okay. I don't got a problem with being rowdy. So, you go right up from Varrock, and then there's this big old eBay area. And that's called the Gand Exchange. Look at how many people are here. Here comes the frog man, folks. Oh, that reminds me, it's Easter. Happy Easter if you celebrate it, folks. You know, there's a lot of beggars over here. Like, this guy's begging for gold, 50k gold. Look at that guy, he says he asks every day. Okay, boys. You know, you can do banking here, and you can do buying. Now, what the heck are we doing? Let me show you how you buy something. Let's buy something. What could I use? Let me go into my stuff and see what I could use. You know, hold on. I'm trying to anticipate. Oh, I could get a large net. And that large net is cheap as, it's real cheap if I remember. So let me grab out like some gold. Let's withdraw like 300. And then you go to this, you offer to buy something. So you bid for something large. What the heck? Don't they got a net? Big vision net. Okay. $207. You know, that's like a suggested price. Confirm, folks. Let's put the bid in. We got it right away. It don't always happen like that. Sometimes people takes a long time. Cause it ain't nobody has an offering yet. There we go, collect the big fish in that. So I need that to catch bass soon enough. So guys, we bought a net. That's pretty cool. We're gonna end this episode right here, folks. And thank you guys for watching. And we will be playing this game quite a bit. And I hope you'll join me for the journey. And you could learn some of this stuff. Well, I do. It's holding out. And if you feel like like support me on Patreon, I could use it, but if you don't, it's okay. I'm just happy you're watching the videos. We'll see you next time. Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dalton, and we're back today with some more RuneScape. Well, some old school RuneScape. And so, you know, I'm where I left off at the last episode. We're here at the Grand Exchange. And I came to the conclusion that today's episode will be dedicated to exploration. So, I'm gonna get like a few items out of the bank. You know, like, let me see. Trying to remember what sword. Okay, adamant sword. So, I'm gonna get like a few items out of the bank. So, adamant centaur for a sword. In case we get into some combat. And then, let's see. How about defense? What the heck can we wear? Dirty. Okay. Adamant armor. Whoops. Okay. So let's stick some adamant armor in the inventory. What the heck, where'd it? Wonder if I'd had got any adamant armor. Oh, I do. You know, I ain't done a lot of fighting in a while in this game. So, I don't really remember. Well, I didn't remember what levels and stuff. So basically, like I said last time, that, you know, the more levels you get, the better crap you can use. So, like, I can use this. Well, you know, at level 35 attack, you know, it could use like an adamant halberd. So, well, I don't even know if we'll need any of this. Hold on, any of this armor. But I just wanted to take a few things. You know, out of the bank. For while we're exploring the place. Okay, I got an amulet of. I think I'm wearing it. No, I ain't wearing it. Hold on. I got an amulet of. I thought I had an amulet of power, too. I got a strength amulet. And there. Oh, that's a game necklace. Well, hold on. Let's put on that amulet of strength, or at least stick it in there. Let's see, what else could we need? I don't think we'll need any arrows. Okay. So, I'm just gonna, like, run around, like, aimlessly. I could look at this map and kind of like get an idea where I should go. But you know, I'm just gonna like walk around and look at stuff. Let's see what's down there, guys. Kilda Grim. Ride minecarts. You know, I didn't even know there was minecarts in this game, guys. But I got good news. You know, there's a lot of crap for me to look for and, like, learn in this game. But the good news is that I'm gonna be playing this game, putting up an episode at least once a week. Let's talk to James. Hey, who are you? I'm James. It's my job to tell you all there is to know about old school pawns. Well, let's talk about what's an old school bond. Allow you to buy a membership using in-game gold. You can redeem them for a free name change. How do you buy one? Get an old school bond from other players from the Grand Exchange. How do you turn it into a membership? 14 days. Well, how much does it cost? Is what I'm trying to figure out. Well, it didn't help me very much, James. Okay, so here's a bank. And this is for Rock. If I ain't mistaken. Hold on. It is for Rock. You know, like, the way I got all of these levels and stuff is that I, like, have a friend who plays a game. And basically, like, I asked him questions every time I wanted to level something. And here he is, Worm Clergy. That's my friend. And he, you know, like, he would show me stuff. But, you know, the thing is, I don't learn stuff if I'm, like, just told something, like, trying to take a head and explain it. Like, if I said, hey, where should I go to fight? To get my attack experience up. And someone told me. And like, I feel like I learn stuff a lot better if I figure it out or look it up. But sometimes I'll listen, go and do something, forget it a second later. What the heck is that person doing? Blowing on a pipe or something. Let's check it out. Are they playing a musical flute? Something cool. I don't know what the heck they're doing. Let's take a look at some of my bank items, guys. I got 609k gold. If you guys donate on Patreon, we could get that in real life. You know, that probably wouldn't take too much. 3 potatoes. Grapes. Chef hat. Got a jug. Let's take a look. Stronghold notes. I found that underneath a barbarian camp. Chisel, what I remember where the heck I got that. Rune essence, we bought at the Grand Exchange. Well, I did at some point. Got a lot of runes my friend gave me. Hold on, let me see something. Wonder what he's up to. Well, I guess we'll just explore. Let's look at some of this stuff. We got a lot of time. You know, I'll be putting one of these out a week. And, you know, depending on, you know, maybe 2 a week. You know, guys, before we go ahead more, wanted to thank all you guys that watched the first episode. You know, because it seemed like a lot of you guys, you know, liked that episode. And, you know, some of you guys asked me about playing together. And I'm sure that could happen down the line. You know, but for now, in today's episode, I'm just gonna walk around. Let's see, my friend gave me a lot of this crap. I got these camo pieces from Drill Sergeant. I don't remember his name, but he was like a bull. And he took me to a drill sergeant training center. And he had me do some sit-ups, push-ups, etc. I got some chocolate bars. Oh, you know, I'm trying to remember what skill that is. Where you turn bars and, well, ore into bars. I don't think it's mining. Blacksmithing. Yeah. You know, I don't think I'll level anything this episode. Hold on. Let me check some of this. Tuna. We got some tuna. Got a harpoon. Okay, without further ado, well, let's dress up differently, actually. Hold on. Let's dress up as, and we don't need this if we're just exploring. So this is an exploration episode, folks. Don't need none of this. Let's dress up as a dang. This is kind of what that guy looked like. He, like, took me to that drill sergeant area. Okay. So, folks. We are here in Varrock. Holy crap, it's a dog. Let's talk to the dog. Fleas all over it. It's too bad we can't take him home as a pet. You know, guys, you can build your own houses in this game. It's construction. Well, what the heck does he question mark mean? Is that his icon? Talk to the tutor. Let's talk to the blacksmithing tutor. Look for the anvil icon to find anvils. You need metal bars to smith. I can teach you the basics. Okay, let's walk around here more. what's up here. What's it like on? It's a purple potion or something. So we're in the town of Iraq. Talk to the apothecary. Brew potions. Do you need anything specific? How about strength potions, please? Where do you get any of that crap? You know, I could look some of this stuff up. Red spider's eggs, limpwort root. So, you need $5, limpwort roots, and red spider's eggs. Let's search a study desk. Old fragments of formulae for mysterious compounds. Okay. Let's go here to the sword icon. No, let's go to the clothes store. I remember this woman. I came here to get my green outfit that we got on. Like that. The green demon. And that's him, folks. Well, let's just be that green demon. How you doing, hippie? If I stop to chat, I'll lose count. Talk to my sister. She likes to chat. You find her upstairs in the church. So, the church is on the map. As a prayer icon. It's above this place. I know you guys can't see my map. So, it's over here. I thought that was a church. I guess it ain't a church. I got a gypsy. What the heck? Silver in the future will be revealed. Where are you going, young one? Well, yes, please, tell me about it, Silver. What the heck, I thought she wanted gold, or I thought that the money was gold in this game. Okay, Barak, who's he? 20 gold each. It's an outrage. Please, give me them for free, please. What the heck? Let's check this place out, guys. Was that the Grand Exchange again? No. Okay. So this is a castle in Barak. Palace. We got a bunch of guards. If you attack them, I bet you all of them turn on you. No way, you can't attack them without the rest of them getting angry. My cats are going crazy outside my door. Okay, so we're up in this palace. Walking around. What's this icon mean? Attack the guard. Hold on, it's over here. Oh, that's an altar. And you pray at him. Okay. I got zero prayer. Well, I mean, I've got 10 prayer. You know, but I'm at zero. Like, you know, charge level. Because it ran out. And this is how you recharge it. Okay, that didn't take long at all, folks. So, hold on. Let's check out the place. Got a bunch of cards. Let's see if you can smack them. Hold on. I think you can. But I don't got any weapons on me. Should have kept a dang. Well, I got an air staff. Can that do anything? Probably not. Got any spells that are free to use? Crap. Let's try smacking one of these guys with the dang air staff. You can attack this. How come I can't learn nothing from it? So, smack it. Learn. Okay. Whoa. Let's see what's in the chest. Nothing in the chest. Come on. That's a little man. Ambassador. Let's talk to that ambassador. Rear fiddle to that king rolled. Well, in theory, he always seems to be busy. You don't seem that upset by that, though. Oh no, I like traveling. And if you become a diplomat, patience is a vital skill. I'll try to remember that. Well, we left the room, so... Where'd he go? Okay, I want to find a guard. I want to see what happens if I smack him one with the dang staff. A suit of armor. May I please have it? Patches. How come you're walking away? Nope. keeps walking away. Now one had to be installed. One had the most marvelous idea. Bring renewed happiness to one's own dearest husband. One common glasses they fill with intolerable levels of exasperation. Swear to be the most true. She's insane. Perfect. Maybe she's got a quest. Of course you. Remember, I thought there was a dog around here somewhere. Passing, I got a question. Seeing as how you put it, do you know of anyone who might have a degree of horticultural experience? And with that, I'd kindly request that I can take your leave now. 25 farming. You may need to practice your farming. So, folks, we're going to make a note. Let their queen, Elamaria, needed level 25 farming. You know, for you to do something for her, I guess. Let me take a look at this farming. What? Which one is that? Oh, there it is. So. So I ain't too sure how to get that farming level up. But we will find out in due time, folks. Holy crap, we got a bear. Well, we could come here and throw magic at the bear. Or I could shoot him with arrows. Cause they can't get to me. Oh, we got yew trees. Let's see, let me look at this wood cutting. Yew trees are available at level 60. Well, that's, you know, 6, well, not 19 levels away. I got yew trees in the Baroque Palace courtyard, folks. What the heck's going on? I don't even know where we're running. Go over here. Let's see what kind of trees they got over here. Yew trees. Oops. Well, it's okay. We took off the mask by accident. But that's okay. Someone dropped some body runes. I'll take them. Thank you very much. Don't mind if I did. Okay, so what is this arrow? Don't know what it means. Well, the tree ain't doing nothing. You know what? Let's teleport. Teleport to Lamp Bridge. Because that's like the beginning area. You know, if we go over there, maybe I could start walking from there. So this is Lump Bridge. It's like the main town. So let's look at this map. We got a toll gate, we got, you know, Valkyrie over there. Land Wars, I ain't never done that. Shantae Pass, I ain't never been there. we just look at this map. We've got the Lumbridge Swamp. Got a quest in the Lumbridge Swamp. Well, I think that's a quest. Hold on, where's the bank? Ain't there a bank at Lumbridge? Well, I guess not, folks. We gotta get a trainer. Okay. Well, let's go here. See if we can get over there. Check out that one. You know, guys, episodes after this one, you know, we're gonna, like, probably explore, but also do quests while I learn all this stuff. You know, and I'll learn stuff on and off of episodes. And if I learn stuff while we ain't playing the game, I'll update next time we play and tell everybody what we learned. So these are goblins, and they don't attack you unless they're provoked. Let's smack them. So he's getting his butt kicked, basically. You know, because I'm level 38 combat. You can take his coins and bones. And burying these bones, it puts, like, points towards your prayer. So, you could probably, you know, like, smack a bunch of these goblins up with a better weapon, like a sword, and then keep burying bones. Oh, water rune, nice. Bury some bones. You know, there's like a million ways to do everything in this game. And like, some are way more efficient than others. What the heck? Let's go down the trapdoor, folks. Pick the lock. Skill. Hopefully it works one of these times. It's given me thief and experience. Crap. Hurting our fingers. In here, folks. Trap door. rocks. What do we got? I got an underground laboratory. I got pipes. Sewer pipes, probably. Well, we got zombies down here, folks. I ain't never been down here before. We're walking through, probably crap. But we don't got any weapons. Except for the staff. Holy crap. Bitch, I could beat him anyway. Smack you with a staff. You better not beat me. Put on some armor. Even if I don't do anything. Wonder if we can beat this zombie smacking him with a staff. You know, I wasn't anticipating any combat, folks. But I suppose that's what happens when you just go exploring. He's going down with a fight. Or it's a lady zombie. Smack him. Please. We're gonna win this fight. We're gonna win the fight. We're gonna smack you down to Chinatown. You don't match. Here you go, folks. Where would you leave? You completed an easy task. Grimy Guam leave. That's the first time I've seen that item. Oh crap, I better run away. They're all gonna try to kill me. Holy crap, are we stuck down here? Hopefully not. Holy crap, we gotta get out. They're all gonna try to kill me. And I... Well, if we had better ammunition. Let's go. Hold on. What's in here? You know, it says there's like a quest. What the heck? Hold on, go down there. No lights. The pixies must have moved on. I hope I see them again. I don't know who the pixies are. How come it won't let me go down there? Learning a lot of stuff in this game. Well, what is right here is called an agility course. You know, this is a rough wall. And I think, you know, my agility's a 31. And I did some agility courses and, you know, this one in this town. This is a trainer. I think we did trainer of agility. Take a look. See how it looks. Yeah, I think I did some trainer of agility. Yeah, these are pretty fun, folks. Holy crap, we're about to advance a level. Get ready. About to be 32. And that's gonna be something else. Jump up the wall. Jump over to hold on, check this out. 360 vision. Check it out. That was cool. And it was mind-blowing stunts. Hold on. You're gonna do... There you go. down the crate. Level up. 32, folks. And that was an agility course. You know, that one's like one of the shorter ones. You know, I've done some. Well, the one I'm on now is... Holy crap, let's get that bird. You need a hunter level. Man, guys, all of this stuff you need levels for. I wanted to catch the imp. Bare-handed imp catching. A bunch of rats. Well, crap, guys, we explored a little bit. You know, there's so much stuff in this game. You know, that's why I said that we're going to be putting out a lot of these episodes. You know, we didn't do much this episode, but I found out some crap. We looked at a few things. We got an agility level. So next time, get excited, because we're going to have some cool things coming across the horizon. Hold on, let's go in here quick. Want to pick some weed. Does that give me a farmer level? Examine the grain. Maybe you could burn the grain. Let's pick a crap plate of grain of wheat. There's a goblin. Pick the wheat. Let's talk to the farmer. How come he won't talk to me? Hey, talk to me, please. Well, guys, like I said, I'll be learning stuff during episodes and, like, outside of episodes. More stuff about the game. Well, let's look at that. On a plow over there. But as far as I'm concerned, folks, we are done with episode 2. You know, guys, thanks for watching. This is a real cool game. And I'm excited to be playing it some more. So, folks, if you liked the video, consider supporting me on Patreon. And, you know, if not, well, thanks for watching anyway, folks. And lots of RuneScape episodes coming. And more videos on the way. And I will see you guys for next time. It's Dalton out. And we'll see you again soon. Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dalton. And we are back today with episode 3 of the RuneScape ASMR playthrough. So, folks, we got a few things to go over before we jump on into what I got planned. Well, before I tell you guys, well, I'll tell you what we're gonna do. We're gonna be building a house today, folks. And also making better, you know, like interiors. So, I got myself a nice plot of land. And I got all of these items over here. We got a bagged plant too. Bagged plant 3. Watering can. 100 oak planks. And these are noted. So that means it's like a, kind of like a IOU for the item. But we got the item, but you gotta get it on noted. We got 60 bolt of cloths, 15 steel bars, 16 teak planks, 4 molten glass, 4 clockwork, 10 mahogany planks, you know, 1 bagged maple tree. We got a bag plant 1, limestone bricks, 24 soft clay. We got a hammer, a saw, iron nails, and some wool. So I got this stuff in preparation for all the crap we're gonna build and add on to the house. You know, but before we go through this teleportation portal, let me show you something, guys. Last episode, I was at 1 fletching, and I advanced 32 levels. You know, the way I did this was I bought a lot of, like, arrow shafts. Well, what did I do? I turned oak wood into... I don't remember what I did now. Hold on. Let's take a look, folks. I think we bought some arrow shafts. And I stuck arrowheads on them. Something like that. You know, this game's got so much crap in it. You know, like I forget what the heck I did. You know, fletching is like making bows and arrows and all that. Well, so, we advanced from 1 to 32 herb lore level. And the way I did that was I bought a bunch of water jars, and I stuck a bunch of like guam leaves in them, or was it teramins, and then like lampwort roots. What did we do? I made some strength potions. This is what we made, some strength potion with teramin and lampwort root. And also, something else. I don't remember, but I did it. You know, there's a lot of crap to remember about this game. Okay, so the other skill was we got 53 construction. You know, I went from 1 to 53. You know, we made a lot of progress there. Let's take a look. You know, I built like a bunch of crap, like I kept making crude chairs. And then I kept making like a, what was that thing called? A larder. You break it, then you keep making it again. You gotta buy a crap load of wood. bunch of nails and just planks. Then you just use oak planks. I also went and got a butler. He was up in, I got the butler over in Ardoyne. He was up here. But now I got a Dienemund butler. Because I got high enough level for it. So let's show you the land, folks. So here we are, folks. We got ourselves the outlinings of like a house. Check it out. We got a Dienemund butler. And he can, you know, do some things for us. He can run and get these notes turned into the actual item. Where, like, if we didn't have him do that, it would be me running back and forth to a guy, and he ain't too far away. But the butler is about a million times faster mathematically. So, let's see. Let me show you. We got ourselves an ice oak table. We got ourselves, well, this is where I was up in my construction level by building a bunch of oak larders over and over and over. What do we got over here, folks? We got another big old oak table. We got a carved oak bench. And, you know, folks, you know, these ghostly objects, that means that you can build something there. So we could build, you know, I'm level 53 construction. So we can build a mahogany bench. We got ourselves a fireplace space. And I think I'm gonna build myself some limestone fireplaces. So, first thing is first. Well, let's finish a quick tour. Let's go over to, you know, the dining room. Well, the living room. We ain't got no TV. You know, we could build a bookcase. We got my bedroom here with a nice king's size bed. And we got the Dienemund butler's room with a nice Dienemund sized bed. And there's a lot of stuff we gotta, you know, do. We gotta, you know, fill in all of these objects with stuff. So, first of all, we gotta do, let's build ourselves some curtains, folks. And that takes bolt cloths and oak planks. So, let me find a butler, or more importantly, I will call the butler, and I will have him do, let me see, can he unnote multiple items is the question, folks. How many did we need for that? I don't remember. flies on his demon wings to go get you that 4 chunks of holy crap. That was quick. He got me 4 chunks of oak. Now I need 4 pieces of what? Bolts of cloth. Please go get it for me. Please get me 4, please. And how many does this take? 3 and 3, folks. Holy crap, well, we don't take too long, so. He's okay. But there's a way I could free up some space in this inventory. We could build some plants. Let's do a small, well, a fern. When we just got a second farming level, folks. Now the question is, let me water it, please. Well, I suppose I can't water it then. Now let me use the bag plant too to make a bush. Holy crap, we advanced another farming level. So, let's hold on. We got rid of 2 items, that's good. Now let's go inside of here and make ourselves a curtain. Let us see a regular old curtain, please. Folks, it did something very good. It made it on both sides. I thought you had to do them individually. But, you know, someone was rooting for us today. And you don't gotta do that. Now, how many items? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Well, let's just keep doing 4 and 4, I suppose. Please hurry up. Yes. 4, please. Go forth on your unholy wings. And please get me a dang curtain. Now go get, please, some more bolts. My humble servant. And we will build more curtains. Holy crap. It built them for the whole room. Folks, that's a game changer. That's good stuff. So I bought too many of them. Cause I figured that they was gonna, you know, only build them on one side at a time. Hold on, the cat is trying to get in here. Let me go and get that cat. So he's not squawking up a storm. Actually, he can stay out there. He should be just fine. Okay, get me some more of this crap, please, if you will. Four, please. You know, folks, I can't drop any of these items in building mode. Okay. Get me some of them, please. Please, 4, if you will. Demon. And he will make his way back. has built another curtain. Crap, hold on. Some of the time this gets messed up if I hover over a certain thing. So, hold on, I believe we got two more rooms to curtain up, and that ain't too shabby. Four is the magic word. Folks, very relaxing game if I do say so. Who's asking for $10,000? Please give me two more. Bolt of cloths. How about two, please? Had we end up with too many planks? Well, it's okay, folks. It ain't a problem. Thank you for the bolts. Oh, this room don't got curtains. And that is okay with me. Okay. So, we got the place curtained up to oblivion. Now hold on, folks. Let's make ourselves a tree. I got a bagged maple tree. But I've got to get it unnoted. So we got to get these two unnoted. And it'll free up that space. Okay. Please go forth from whence you came. And please get me a darn bagged maple tree. I wonder if he holds it in his mouth while he's flying back. You know, that's gotta be pretty hard to fly around with a maple tree in your mouth. Okay, folks. What happened to the tree? Hold on. What the heck? What did I do, folks? Yes. One, please. What happened to my maple tree? Folks, I think that I accidentally had him take it to the bank. Well, that's okay. Got a bag plant one. I don't think we can plant it as a tree though. That was an expensive tree. So, let us see what is next on my list. I would like to probably make a chair if I must, please. There we go. And it's a handsome chair. Now, what are we focusing on next? I will ponder and venture to guess. How about a teak drawers? How about get me, please, 4 teak wood pieces, please? Where is? Okay. Where the heck? Please get me 4 of these. Greetings, my friends. Holy crap. You can change clothes. Holy crap, guys. It's the first time I've ever seen this. Shoes. Where the heck are they at? I can't see them. Okay. But it's fine. Looking pretty cool now. Let us build one for Mr. Demon, please. Over and upward. Here, folks. Clack it in. Hammer the nails. Build some rugs. How about a standard rug, folks? We will need 4, 8, 12, and I believe just 12 for them rugs. He's got an extra. That's okay. Let's build a rack, folks. Here we go. Oh, that looks great. He had my extra piece. Extra bolt of cloth. We can build a brown rack. Let's select for the red rack. And it's a little more distinguished. This is a double rug space. Oh, that's a singular rug. No kidding. So, let's see. Let us build. How about a cat basket space, which requires 2 planks. 2 nails, 2 wool. May I use an oak plank, I wonder? I hope so. If not, my plan is foiled. Okay, so, let me see how many cat basket spaces there is. We got one. We got ourselves 2 cat. Wait a second. 1 cat basket space. So, let me look at that again. I don't remember. And it's 2 planks, 2 wool. We already got the 9-inch nails. Hold on. 2 plank, 2 wool. and I hope they let me use oak planks. chapel. So, to counterbalance the demon auras, we will need to build an altar. How about a teak altar, folks? I believe it will take 4 teak planks. What the heck? We got steel bars. Oak plank nails and steel bars. We can make some wind chimes. 4 steel bars. Hold on, we gotta get the altar first. 4 teak planks. Okay. A demonic energy is breaching the older room. Scary things are happening. Okay, let us build the deke older. And he feels his powers weaken, folks. What is that? Holy crap. What is this stuff? Well, it's pretty cool anyway. Let's build it. Windows. Molten glass. We got molten glass. Sadly, we only have 4. And I didn't anticipate building the chapel of anti-demonic energy, folks. Hold on, we need 4 steel bars, 4 steel planks. Hold on, 4 steel bars, please. 4 is the magic number, and then 4 oak planks. There he is, sneaking up like, you know, he's a trickster. Let us see. There we go. Let us build some chimes. Beautiful. Oh yeah, I forgot about bending the nails. You bend the nails. Statue space. Do we have any more limestone? I don't believe so. That's okay, folks. How about steel? Bolt of cloth. Hold on, let me look at the lamp. Steel bars. So we need 4 bolt of cloths. Outside, it takes him a while to get to ya. Okay. Crap, hold on. What the heck for? to the statue, and the room has come, will come together quite nicely, folks. You know, we can build a oak bench. Well, how about it? Mahogany bench. 4 mahogany planks. This will be what we do. 4 of these, please. To build ourselves a dining table accent capable of accommodating some guests to come over and eat foods on the table. And that is it. Holy crap, it ain't mansion, folks. Well, I ain't a mansion kind of guy, so that just so happens to be a very good thing. Holy crap. 5 steel bars, pump and drain. Let us give the demon the 5 to retrieve from the bank. Chocolate bars for the hungry man. Man, we are building a dang. I don't even know what the heck it was called again. Okay, build please to pump and drain. Now, what is this? Running water in your own home. Wow, we now have a water source. Now that is pretty cool. Now what the heck? Oak plank 3, soft clay 6. Okay, 6 soft clay. 3 oak planks. Let us do that. What the heck were the numbers again? I don't even remember. 3 planks, 6 clays. 3 planks, 6 clays. Marshmallows, or go and they would taste like Play-Doh. in the clay kiln fireplace, folks. Pretty good looking house so far. Let me see. So, folks, for the next episode, I believe I will finish furnishing the house and we will go over the new changes. We also may get into some farming. There's a whole realm of possibilities and it's exciting stuff, guys. So, I hope you all enjoyed the video today. And if you did, consider supporting me on Patreon. And if not, thank you anyway for watching the videos. And we will see you for the next one, guys. And that is Dalton out. Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dalton. And today, back with another RuneScape video. You know, I ain't advanced any stats since last time. Well, kinda due to the fact that I ain't played since last time. But we got an exciting quest we're gonna go and get did. And it is called The Witch's Quest. And you know, I already like did like half of it, but there's still a little bit more to do. And so we will need a few items. Let us check. Let me see what we got. Let's bring an attack potion. We gotta have all these cheeses. You know, hold on, and we need the amulet of power. Sword is asking Dalton, do you whisper everything you do when you play? Sometimes. Looks like he's got a, you know, like a helmet next to his head. Which means, like, that means he's like a moderator, I guess. Okay, hold on. Gotta get back on track. Gonna need, like, let's see. Well, I know we need, you know, like, armor and stuff. But, you know, well, we're gonna need lobsters. Because we need to heal quite a bit. Okay, we need a magnet that I got. Don't know where the heck I put that magnet. You know, I probably chucked it in the general item selection. Don't remember what it looked. There it is. It's a stereotypical magnet, folks. So now we gotta stick on some armor. Let me check the levels. Okay, we need adamant. And I think it's the same for everything. Well, we'll just stick on, you know, like, yeah, like adamant. Well, we could get samurai armor. Don't know Let's make our way up there. You know, it's up here, it's cold. Just the town of Taylor V. Well, we got a quest over here. Curious as to what it could be. Let's talk to Doric. You know, this might be a quest. Maybe we'll find out about some cool stuff. Nurmoth has a store over in the Dwarven Mine. Upon the entrance on the side of Ice Mountain. East. Let's see if we got a new quest. That ain't it. Well, I don't know how to get the quest. Checking out the land. Enjoys the solitude. Okay, where the heck's the Dwarven Mine? So if maybe if we go there, we get the quest or something. Hold on, let me check again. Is there someone else in here? Let's go to sleep in his bed. We got a problem. Forgot the dang key. But hold on. Let's just keep trying. for that plant. You know, I was under the impression that, that, you know, we already unlocked it and that it would be unlocked forever. You know, the problem is, don't really know which key it is. But this is good. Let's talk to the boy and see what he's got to say. We'll say, what the heck? They don't got a bank up here, I don't think. Well, Burthorpe is just up the mountain. So we could either go to Burthorpe or Falador. Well, which one's closer, folks? I ain't been to Burthorpe in a while, so let's go up there. But first, let's talk to little boy. I'd already have some, like, sort of like intel on, you know, getting, the dang ball back. Well, we got a quest. How do you do it? It's Dr. Silas. Well, he's got a cool get up, folks. Magic beans to plant. Who the heck's got the quest if he don't talk to us? Well, let's stay focused on this. So I suppose we already took the key and then we can't get it back. Let's go up to Burthorpe. Let me check out this quest though. What the heck, who's got the quest? That's Heroes Guild. You gotta have a lot of quest points. Which I only done a few quests. You know, I've mainly just leveled so far. Hope we can get in there. This place. You know, I don't know if we can get in there because it's like a warrior's place. Over there. Well, let's try it out. You don't know unless you try. Oh, that's a mountain. I thought that was like a path. So this is like a big old lock. You gotta get in through that door or that door. Let's talk to Gomo. Let me in, please. What the heck? Are. You know, I guess. Oh, okay. You know, that other entrance is probably locked. Well, folks, let's trek on back to the dang, down to, like, you know, down to, like, you know, Falador. You know, we came to do the witch's quest. so much to remember. Okay, let us find a key. Well, that was an accident, but we'll kick his butt. Oh, we gotta talk to Leo. Hopefully he stays here. Skeleton with, like, you know, a sword and axe and a logs. Well, let's keep looking at these graves. Got a water bucket. So this guy is like logs and, you know, like axes and swords. So let's check and see. Okay, that might be the one to put him in. So this is like this guy. Use it on that. It's gotta be the right one. Axe. And that one had an axe too. This one's got like a apron and like a pickaxe. Let's see which one he goes in. Not that, probably. Probably this. At the chef head. The heck was his? There we go, folks. So, we know that these two, we did them already. So let's take this coffin. And this coffin. So, this and this. It's a, don't know what the heck it is, but we could check shears and stuff. Well, hold on. That's like shears and, I think that's equipment for, we can't check our stats. That was equipment for like crafting, I think. Met the chef hat. Any of these got chef items in them? Well, them are pots. Had like a clay kiln or something. Well, let's stick a potion in the mausoleum. Let's stick, well, we'll put a lobster in there. Okay. Let's take this coal. let's check this again. I don't remember what it is. You know, I don't remember what that is. Check this one quick. Okay, we got a water in, like. Dang. Check this. Okay, I think this is for that.
So
We gotta go. we go up to, you know, right up here to Taverly, and that's where the quest is. So let's set off, folks. You know, it'll be pretty exciting. Just gotta follow the dirt gravel road up to there. You know, and use the shortcut. There it is. You climb under the tag wall. And there we go, folks. So let us make our way to the bank. Gotta get a few key items out of that bank. And I believe they are pieces of cheese. You know, like a big old magnet. And a key. Cause you know, I couldn't get in the witch's house without a key. So, you know, don't think I need the gold. Let's put all of it in there and all the bones. But you know, so I think let me take a look. You know, I will need a key. Cause that's, I think, a witch house key. Yeah, that's a witch house. How about that one? Yep, there we go, folks. Taking a few cheese chunks. Cause it's possible to fail. You know, to like fail. I'll show you. Okay, we need a magnet. Chain body. finally. You know, let's read the witch's diary. Experiment is growing larger daily. Making excellent progress. Currently feeding it on a mixture of fungus, tar, and clay. Seems to like this combination a lot. Experiment still going extremely well. Moved it to the wooden garden shed. Does too much damage in the house. It's getting real strong now. But unfortunately, it's not too intelligent yet. It has a really mean stare too. Sausages for dinner tonight. Lovely. A guy called Professor Altenstein installed a new security system for me in the basement. Seems to have a lot of good ideas. So, folks, I already did the part where you go in the basement and you find a magnet inside of a crate. Don't want people getting into the back garden to see the experiment. Professor Altenstein is fitting me new security system after his successful installation in the cellar. That pesky kid keeps kicking his ball into my garden. I swear if he does it again, gonna lock his ball away in his shed. Security system's done by Zamorak. Wow, is it contrived? Now to open my back door, I lure a mouse out of a hole in the back porch. I fed a magic curved piece of metal to the harness on its back. The mouse goes back in a hole when the door unlocks. You know, the professor tells me that this is cutting-edge technology. As an added precaution, I hid the key to the shed in a secret compartment at a fountain in the garden. No one will ever look. So, folks, we gotta go and find that key in the secret compartment. Still can't think of a good name for the experiment leaning towards Fritz. Although, I'm considering Lucy, as it reminds me of my mother. Okay, folks, so, gotta go right here. Yeah, this is locked. So, you put like a piece of cheese on the mouth hole. Well, that was an accident. Use. And then you use the magnet on the mouse. Strange whirring noise from above the door frame. There we go, folks. So this is the witch. She's patrolling the garden, folks. We can't let her see us. Let's see. Well, it's a real long garden, so should be okay. She keeps like walking by. Careful. You know, what the heck? So there's like a fountain. So this door is, you know, you can't get in here. Gotta go to the fountain. You know, I think you get there this way. That's a big bear, folks. Holy crap, we're kicking butt. I thought we was gonna die. There's a wolf. The wolf will be fought. And he is strong, folks. Let's get in on the action here. You know, we're blocking a lot of these shots. That rune armor's really doing, you know, us a lot of good. Shapeshifter once and for all. Okay, so. Well, the question is, do we take the ball? Or do we talk to the witch? Or do we just get the ball and leave? Let's examine a child's ball. Okay, folks. Let us take it back to the boy. Holy crap, hope she can't see me there. Just keep her running, folks. Okay, here we go. Gonna give the ball back to the boy. Completed the witch's quest. You are.